equine trainer was just a spur, put a spur on him, get him, and put a spur back on her, and she said no. So that was the end of that trainer.
Yep.
And then he went away for a month to another trainer that he went pretty well for, I think.
Yep.
And she did a lot of groundwork with him.
Yep. Again.
The way groundwork works really well, before you have to hop on them, is it warms the horse's body up a little bit. So you kind of warm up any muscles or any issues that are going on. And a lot of horses have that warm-up to them, right? But if you were to hop on them cold, that's when you get the naughtiness and the issues. So I'm going to run through. I'm not going to ask him a lot at the moment. I'm just going to feel him. So he's unsound behind in the offline, the near hind, sorry. That's just dragging one back toe, and if you have a look on the sand, if I trot really close to the fence, you can see the scuff marks in the sand from his back legs. Okay, so that you can, I can hear them dragging, you can feel them dragging. If I ride really close, you can notice that the back end is dragging them. You can pick it up off the ground, and so whenever we go to the beach, whenever we ride on our arena, when it's freshly harrowed, I'm always studying everyone else's drag marks. Some horses will just drag one back toe, others drag both back toes. So that tells me that he physically is catching and he can't come up through his body. Good boy. So good. The other way. Good boy. So happily goes through that corner.